At the time that they were casting for this role, in this film actually, I was doing a Broadway show called Fences, a legendary piece, with James Earl Jones and Mary Alice, a stellar cast. And they brought in some of the actors from that show because it was such a hit.
Okay, now what the f you want?
We desire a room.
Now, originally, I wasn't contracted to play the role of the landlord, which is very interesting.
Hey, Stu, your rent's due, mother. And don't be pulling that falling down the stairs on me, you hear? Are you conscious?
But as showbiz legacy, history, whatever happens sometimes, the guy who was contracted to play my part, he was in another film and he couldn't get out of it. It was complicated. So he couldn't do it. So they immediately went out and they said, well, and they remembered my work, and John Landis brought me back in. And at this point he wanted to see me for two roles. He wanted to see me for McDowell and he wanted to see me for the landlord.
Excuse me if I was brusque, but sometimes we get boo-boos in here without a dollar to their name. But obviously you gentlemen came in on another boat.
We seek meager accommodations.
Excuse me?
John gave me permission, you know, said, you need to do something to make it more yours, you know, feel more natural for you, that's fine, go ahead with it. But with, you know, Eddie and Arsenio and, you know, and the chemistry was there, was just so right. I just like rolled with it. They rolled with it, and it was hysterical times.
Now, this is the place that I was telling you about. It's real f***ed up. Got just one window facing a brick wall. Used to rent it to a blind man.
In one of my favorite lines of his, which really, you know, show in my mind who he is when the boys, they open the door and he's showing the room, and you got all these insects and flies buzzing all around. He says, yeah, we got a little bit of an insect problem, but you boys used to that. So that paved the way to a lot of insight to a lot of characters that I play. Teaches you to just relax and be in the moment.
Damn shame what they did to that dog.
We will take the room.
My favorite scene is, God, I just, so many stuff, so much stuff. I particularly love the stereotype that they portray in the scene in which the guys, when the pursuer is sitting down in the chair, gets up, and then there's the grease mark on the back of the chair. When you're gonna sit in the chair with jerry curl stuff in your hair and get up off the fabric, you're gonna leave that jerry curl fabric, I mean oil on that chair. I mean, I have a huge body of work, but no matter what somebody says, you know, well, tell me, because I don't like to, you know, to say, oh, I did this move, I did that. They say, well, I know I've seen you in something. I say, okay, Coming to America. That's it, you know, blah, blah, blah. So that's always, it works good for me, or very well for me, because it's something that I can always give them, and then they'll leave me alone. They say, yeah, okay, Coming to America. I know you've been in a lot of other stuff, but whoa, the landlord and Coming to America, wow, you know.
I took the responsibility seriously and held it very close to my heart.